I've spoken to you guys about my French journey so far, and I'm a little farther along the journey than you are. Wouldn't it be fair to introduce you guys to the struggle of language learning while I'm doing it? I want to take you guys through the little victories and the little failures of my journey of learning a new language. And last week I did just that in Hindi.
Sunday ko main baithta hu shaam ko, socha tum logon ko bhi invite kar lu, tum log bhi aa jao Zoom mein, link ping bhejta hu. Wo French ke time ke hisab se 5 baje ko milte hain, ab ke time ke hisab se 8:30 baje. Yahi Gymbody wala funday se Sunday ko mil lete hain, baat cheet kar lenge.
Many of you guys turned up and it was fun to work with you. We worked together for 40 minutes using the Pomodoro technique and then hung out for the next 20 minutes where we introduced ourselves and spoke about our goals. Many of you knew exactly what you were doing during the 40 minutes. But for those of you who are curious, here's how I spent my 40 minutes. There's a good amount of planning that happened off camera, so I'll walk you guys through the planning first and then we'll get to what I did exactly during the 40 minutes. I first set myself a goal using this framework. I created this framework from my experience of learning French. If you feel a little lost setting up your goal, then hit me up on Instagram and I'll walk you guys through my framework over a video call. Make sure to pick only one step ahead of where you really are at instead of picking two steps or three steps ahead. Everyone wants to be on level 7, but a realistic goal would be 1 plus from where you're at. Unless you have a lot of time each day, then pick 2. Once you set your goal, then collect your material. In fact, 30 minutes before we caught up, I prompted you guys to do this. And if you were lost about what does he mean by material, then here is what I did. Now, this step is crucial for me because if I skip this step, then during my work hour, I'll spend my time looking up things online and I'll feel that I've been working. Well, in fact, I was just looking up stuff. Now, don't get me wrong. If you want to read blogs about learning your target language, by all means, do that. But just count that as preparation. Don't count that as work. During your work hours, do more of exercising and less of reading about the language. So for my material, I count on Google Docs, Google Sheets and Keep more specifically, Anki Droid, a bunch of translators and the Magic Element. The Magic Element is anything that you consider fun and that you want to sound like. Of course, you can't understand movies and TV shows when you're starting from scratch. I really don't mind consuming content that was made for kids because they go so slow and they articulate so well. I don't want to sound like that, of course, but it's nice that someone slows down for you and you can really get the words individually. Now, I'm not much of a reader, so I don't read many books. I relied on a lot of music, TV shows, movies. If you're an adult, I'm sure you already have your preference of consuming media. Find that alternative in your target language and that's your magic element. Or just look at this framework that I spoke about and think about what will take you to the next step in your target language. And look up that kind of content and consume that kind of content. For me, in my current level of Dutch, I see that my vocabulary is very limited and that's what I'm working on using these comic strips. So when I see something that I don't understand, I look it up and once I'm sure that's what it means, thanks to these translators, I put it into my Anki Droid or my Google Sheets. The words go into Anki Droid and the phrases go into Google Sheets. But if I'm lost someday with Anki Droid or I mistranslated something, I also have access to the context where it's from. Now this is backbreaking work because after 40 minutes of work, this is the small list that I came up with. It might be a little disheartening when you start off because you don't know many words and you are going to be slow. But think about it like this. When your teacher was teaching you numbers in your primary, kindergarten, school, she didn't spend that much effort teaching you the sequence between 1221, 1222, 1223, and 1224. Like she did with 1, 2, 3, and 4. That was more difficult. This was easier because it's a similar pattern. The same will happen with your language journey. The first 300, 400 words are going to be challenging. Once you've got them out of the way, it'll be far easier to acquire new words. Just look at my list from my French journey from all these years. I didn't use Anki Droid all this while, but I've used Google Sheets. So I have a huge list of words and phrases that I picked up from TV shows and stuff because that's the amount of things you learn just by watching TV or YouTube or just having fun. So when I was in a metro all this while, I wasn't using Anki, as I said, I would just draw an S on my phone and it would launch Google Sheets. I would open up my list and I would just go through these things, trying my best to make a sentence from the words you see over here. And going through this list, I can already see patterns, the ones that I made when I was on the farm, the ones that came from my favorite TV show 10%, from Bref, from Bloqué, from the songs that I've been listening to. It comes full circle. Now there's this joke by Trevor Noah where he's talking about his German learning journey. Have a listen.
I speak German. Sometimes I sound distinctly Hitlerish. Guten Tag! Ich will ein kleinen Boten haben, bitte schön! und ein Pepsi Cola trinken, bitte. And she looked me straight in the eye and she said, der schwarze Hitler.
Of course, he means it in satire, but this is really true. What you consume a lot of is what you end up sounding like. That's where I'm at today. In a few months, this is not what it's going to look like. I'll probably be doing more conversation than reading comic book strips. If you're curious about my language learning journey, then definitely subscribe to be updated every time I make a video of progress. But if you want to join our work group on Sunday evenings or just want to hang out and ask questions during the Q&A, then hit me up on Instagram and we'll stay in touch. If you like this video, then I'm sure you'll also like the one where I spoke about my French journey and this one where I'm talking about how I improved my French communication. Give it a thumbs up because it definitely helps the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in and I'll see you guys around. Keep learning.